We're basically interested in the land and how the land affects the atmosphere and how the atmosphere affects the land. RELÁMPAGO Hydromet has kind of two big observational components. One is the streamflow measurements, but we were here back in May. Throughout the watershed, we installed 30 MET stations and 7 flux towers. So we'll have a year of continuous measurements throughout the basin. It's been critical for us to partner up with people like Marcelo. This is their watershed. They know it intimately well, and they know the communities that are affected by changes in streamflow and flooding.
When we have a flood, we go to the field and we take videos, we put the instrument on water. Today we were working in we call it a regatta. We put all the instruments on the water just to check that they are working well. We use 2 acoustic Doppler profilers just to measure discharge. And then we are using also the techniques, using digital videos.
The response of these rivers is really intense. A lot of the measurements have measured changes on the order of 12, 20 times their natural flow.
I thought that the rise in the river level was going to be gradual. When I actually experienced this event, though, you could actually look in the distance and see the flood wave arriving.
Y ese es un pedazo, porque queda un pedazo allá y otro pedazo acá.
No. Hay una tormenta eléctrica bastante fuerte y bueno, y empezó a caer granizo. Y bueno, primero eran chiquititas, normales, y después empezaron a caer más grandes, como el de una pelota de tenis. Y después cayó una muy grande, más o menos así.
Whenever there's a severe mission, we head out with the hail pads. The hail pad is the lowest tech instrument that we have at RELÁMPAGO. It's literally a piece of styrofoam covered in tin foil. And we affix it to a metal plate and screw it in there and then just basically jam it into the ground. These will measure the size of the impacts from the hailstone, so we can get some information about the distribution of hailstone sizes at any location. It's very difficult to do, but because of this sort of nice natural laboratory that we have here with storms initiating almost every day, it gives us our best chance to measure some good data sets.